So now, if a person is looking for trouble, you see, when we're looking for faults, and the Jews were looking for trouble against Jesus, any excuse, every excuse, slight as something he says, they pick up stone again to stone him. Why? Because they say, you claim such and such a thing. You blaspheme, you blaspheme. They were always continuously out to get him out, to catch him out, because they didn't like his preaching. Why the Jews took exception? They were taking exception to everything. You see, in John chapter 10 verse 30, you remember, they took up stones again to stone him. You know why? Because he said, I and my Father are one. You read that context and you find it's a series of deliberate misunderstanding. See, when you're looking for trouble, you get it around the corner. You don't have to go very far. This is human beings. Every innocent expression you make, I can find fault with it. You know that? Like the word son is my son. So what do you mean? You knew my mother? I said, no, son, I don't mean that. You still call me a son? You know, you can bash me on the jaw. It has happened to me. See, in my country, which is a country, you know, full of color separation, apartheid. I'm traveling in a bus, Pullman bus. I don't know, you have things like that here. From the North Coast, where I got married, and I'm coming to Durban, you know, where I live and I work. After a weekend, I am returning, I'm sitting in the bus. And while this bus is passing now through Durban, the city where I live, and I can see that it's going to the central station, but it passes Alice Street, where I work. So I walk up to the driver, and I ask him, excuse me, brother, does this bus stop anywhere near Alice Street? If so, then I can pull the string and nearer to get to work, instead of going to the station and then walking back 2 miles. If it is stopping anywhere near Alice Street, it's passing Alice Street, I know it's crossing it. So he said, no. Not like he barked, he said, no. I said, maybe sometimes, you know, we do speak with jerks, unintentionally. You know, I speak a bit too loud when I didn't mean it. You see? He said, no. So I go and sit back on my seat. So he takes me to the central station. No alternative. By hydraulics, the doors are opened. I get down, I'm still holding the rail, one leg on the ground, and the leg is other one on the, still on the platform. So he leaves his steering and he rushes to me. He says, don't you call me your brother. He says, call those coolies your brothers. So what happened? I'm stunned. I don't know what's going on. He says, don't you call me your brother. Call those coolies your brothers. I'm counted as a coolie. Coolie means a laborer. You see, some of my people, they had gone to South Africa as laborers. So they divide the people into Africans. They call them Kaffirs. Colors are mixture between black and white. They call them Hottentots, Hottentots, Bushmen. See, me, I'm a coolie, whether Hindu, Muslim or Christian. So he says, don't you call me your brother, call those coolies your brothers. But I don't know what happened. You know, it's so sudden, I didn't mean anything. No, he took it that way. And I'm stunned, if he had a gun, he would have shot me. My God, fortunately he didn't have one. So this is, if you're looking for trouble, innocent expression. He was a brother, I said, you still call me up my brother? You know, he could have punched me, you know that? So, Mr. Word, retreat, honorable retreat, I did.